Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus Gateway Community College.
Welcome everybody to Bishop Connolly High School here in Fall River, Massachusetts, the home of the Bishop Connolly High School Cougars and also the home of the Bristol Community College Bayhawks. The men's Bayhawks comes into Region 21, comes into this contest leading Region 21, and they're going up against the Gateway Community Lions, Gateway Community College Lions of New Haven, Connecticut. Hi, I'm David Cardoza. Alongside me is the Portuguese Cowboy, Craig Salvador. He's also, after 8 o'clock, known as the Portuguese Terror. And on the fancy cam work is DP, Miss Denise. And we're getting ready for tip-off. It's the Baker Man. And the tip is won by Gateway Community College. Long pass out of bounds. What's going on, Craig? We're coming off a contest where the BCC women's team was blown out of the gym, 92-70 against Gateway Community College. Hopefully the men's team doesn't have that same fate.
Yeah, exactly. Looking for a different performance from the men's team. Hoping to pick up a win. At least go 1-1 against Gateway between our two teams.
BCC in white.
This is interesting. We're seeing Luis Rosario start. We usually don't see him start. Usually just coming off the bench.
And in the women's game, we've seen different starters for them as well.
We're going into postseason play pretty soon. You got to, you know, switch things up, keep things fresh.
That's for sure. Now's the time to do it. Three-point shot for Gateway. No good. Going up high for the rebound was Pope. And it's going to be Bristol ball.
No foul. Just apparently just went out of bounds.
Saturday afternoon basketball from the cathedral. Lions look like they're in zone. Pope here to Rosario.
That's some really good passing motion from BCC.
Rosario, three-pointer, no good. Rebounded by Jernigan. You know what I was thinking also? I believe this is the last home game.
This is the last home game before postseason.
This is the last home game. Luis Rosario, sophomore, getting the start. Pope for three, going to step.
He is a sophomore. This is going to be his last season here with the Bayhawks.
Yeah, so the senior getting the start in his final contest here at home. So yep. It makes all the sense.
Like to see him have a good game as his farewell for the regular season,
but then
at
again,
home at least.
But then again, Ryan Stopkins is a sophomore too. Could have been a hell of a backcourt there. Alec Newman with the basketball playing at the point. BCC matching up man, as they like to do.
That was a hard pass.
Ooh, loose ball. Mercado coming away with it. Mercado driving the lane, going up strong. Had his shot altered, and nonetheless, Gateway Community College with the basketball. Losing the basketball is Sericio. Sloppy play going on the first couple minutes.
I think this is the longest start we've ever seen to a men's game without anybody scoring.
That's for sure. Jumper by Mercado, no good. Rebounded by Roger Hamlet. Roger Hamlet, a 6'3" center, freshman center. As the women's Gateway Community College team had some height, so does in this men's team. Rosario leading the way, trying to get it inside. Finds Jernigan somehow, gets it off the glass and rolls it in.
It's a good play. Newman had it bounce off his foot. Good recovery from the Bayhawks.
And we get the first basket 17 and a half minutes in. I mean, 2 minutes in. 2.5 minutes in, I'm sorry.
Math.
Jumper, Sericio is good. And both teams on the board now. Quick timeout.
I still have the women's roster in front of me. I can get rid of that.
And a quick timeout after that basket by Coach John Stewart. Head coach John Stewart of Gateway Community College. Men's basketball teams assisted by Mark Scott. And of course, men's basketball team coached by longtime coach Rob Del Lue. In his eighth season as BCC coach, over 100 wins. Went to the regional finals last year, looking to get back there this year. And we're approaching that time of the season in college basketball. February starts heating up, the end of the regular season, going into tournament play, conference tournament play, and then, you know, national tournament.
Getting into nitty-gritty territory.
Yeah, we're heading towards March Madness, right?
That's going to be fun to call.
It is. Baker was surrounded by blue shirts and coming away with it. Look at that bounce pass.
Nice pass.
The three-pointer is drilled by Newman on the pass from number 21, Roger Hamlet, finding him in the corner. Brilliant play there. 5-2 early. It's Cardoza and Salvador on the call. Referee just warning Newman. Said if you reacted like that again, it'd be a technical foul. Players are going to show emotion. You know what I mean? It's a game. It's competitive. Nothing was directed towards the ref or another player.
I don't want to turn into the no fun league.
Yeah, and that ball goes out of bounds. Turnover by Gateway. Thrown out of bounds. Quincy Pope. Yeah, no Marcus McCarthy in the starting lineup. No Daniel Mendez. Mercado for three. No good.
I was a little disappointed that during your intros you didn't call him Jose Can You Three.
I know. I want him to come back down to earth. I called the Pope. I called Quincy Pope the Pope, though.
You did call him the Pope.
So I kind of...
I guess it may, I don't know, evens out maybe. I mean, it's also because it's not a nickname, it's just his name.
That's true.
It'd be like if I called you the Cardoza.
Yeah, but he could be Quincy Pope, but is he the Pope?
That's true.
Sericio gets it inside.
Big travel.
And they're going to call steps. Again, sloppy play here in the first 4-plus minutes. And this is the final home game, so I had a chance to Jose Can You Three all day, and up is it.
Jernigan.
Pope with the miss, Jernigan with the putback. There's been Jernigan that feels like an unsung hero on this team.
We've been saying that all season long.
He does the dirty work. In the corner, Sericio. Oh, inside. In the paint is good. Jumper is good. Lewis Burks, 6'3" forward.
Oh, Newman with
a big... Oh, almost a steal by Newman.
Newman intercepted it, realized he was going out of bounds, tried to get rid of it, but Bayhawks just picked it right back up.
Kind of helter-skelter play. Newman leading the break.
Pope
slides.
He went for a pass. Pope just stuck the foot out and blocked it.
They're going to call a kickball on him. It's going to stay in the Lions' possession. Lions in that Warrior blue, gold numbers, letters.
Gold letters.
7-4, they lead. Alex J. Newman for three.
In, out, and back in.
Two three-pointers for him early. 10-4. Baker being trapped in the corner.
That was a tough pass. Give him credit. He was able to get it to Rosario.
Jernigan comes up on top. Always getting collapsed on. Lions doing a good job of collapsing on BCC players. They're all over Baker.
BCC likes to play down under, and they're blocking them this far.
And Baker usually has that move on the baseline, or he's able to maneuver down there and create space for himself and get baskets, but they're collapsing all over him when he gets the ball down there. He's got no breather room. He threw up that last shot sideways, got the foul call.
Brick.
Armani Baker is actually the leading scorer. He's a leading scorer and leading rebounder. He's averaging a double-double.
Yeah, I was just going to say, we've been seeing him get double-doubles all season long, so it's not very surprising.
Yeah, he's been a double-double machine. He's also a two-year starter. Played on last year's team. A team that was finalists in both state and region tournaments. Sericio. Oh, nice pass. Oh, but was that blocked? Definitely altered by Mercado. Blocked.
He came down with it, but lost it immediately.
Oh, it was a nice pass by Burks to get it inside. And we're going to have another timeout in the court. It's definitely a slippery spot over there.
I remember the last game we called, everyone was slipping all over the place.
Slipping inside, and it's like there's ice underneath there.
Yeah, enough ice outside. We don't need it inside. It is hockey season, though.
It is. It's the winter. The winter sports are finally taking over. Yep. Baseball pitches and catches, though, report next week.
Yep, spring training starting soon.
That's the one good thing. You know, it's with baseball starting up, you kind of feel like spring is coming, although it's
and then you
really
realize
not.
They start in February, spring training early March.
And then you realize they're in Florida and we're up here.
Yep.
10-5. 14-20. It's early here. Saturday afternoon. Bayhawks basketball. Final home game of the season for these Bayhawks. With just a couple more games left on the schedule.
Listen to that floor.
That floor is coming apart right now at the seams. It's like the old parquet in the Boston Garden. A little slippery. And as we wait for that, and of course I'm going to plug the Dirty Water Sports Hour Tuesdays on bccradio.org. At 4 p.m., championship edition, highlighting the Patriots Super Bowl championship win.
How Tom Brady was cemented as the GOAT.
I think he was already cemented as the GOAT.
But now he's truly the greatest.
Just, that, if he had a loss, you know, people would have been, there's the naysayers. 2-3 zone, GCC in. Baker comes up and gets it. Takes it to the rack, can't get it. Fighting for the rebound, and there's going to be a jump. Possession arrow in the favor of, I think BCC is going to keep it here.
Yep. BCC's ball.
Bristol ball.
And coming. Danny Mendez, Marcus McCarthy coming in.
And they'll come in for Mercado and Luis Rosario. So number 23, Marcus McCarthy in the game with number one, Danny Mendez.
I said this last game, I really like this duo that Mendez and McCarthy have together. They got great chemistry and they're both very good shooters.
They can handle the basketball, they can shoot, you're right.
Both very quick, very agile. They're a good force to be reckoned with.
That's the truth. Jernigan. He's going to get fouled. He's going to be fouled by number 34. Number 34.
Lewis Burks.
Lewis Burks. Lewis Burks stands at 6'3". Roger Hamlet is 6'3". Rudy Sauricio is 6'3". Bunch of 6'3ers.
Luis Vega, 6'5".
Yeah, he's not even out there yet. He's 6'5", 220. Freshman center. He's on the bench right now. From Shelton, Connecticut. BCC to inbound. From just underneath their own basket. McCarthy, Baker, driving to his left. Puts it up, try to go strong.
Jernigan almost got the rebound.
And they can't come up with anything.
Both teams playing kind of sluggish to begin this.
Yeah, it is sluggish. BCC a little bit more sluggish right now. Get a good crowd here now for the afternoon game here.
Yeah, after it was dead during the first game, it's good to see people coming out to support the men's team.
Yeah, I like to see a little something, something. Let's go. Saturday afternoon basketball, baby. Let's go. February. Mm-hmm.
It's basketball season. No more football. No excuse not to watch basketball.
Yeah, come in here. Bring your little flask of vino. You know, Portuguese terror style. Anyway, let's go. Let's go.
Let's go.
Feel a little bit more energy in the gym now. That ball goes out of bounds. It's going to be Bayhawks basketball. Both teams with good-sized rosters, so we're not like playing 5-on-5 forever.
Yeah.
Here's Marcus.
Going to be ready for a fast-paced game.
That's for sure. Got to get that ball out of that corner.
Gateway playing with some very good coverage.
McCarthy, he's going to take it. Goes up and under. Loses the basketball. Baker going up strong with it. Can't get it. That was a big guy. That's number 50, Emmanuel Kamara. He's 6'1", 200. Driving the lane, A.J. going up strong. Another putback by number 21, Roger Hamlet. 12-5 early. Gateway really playing that extended zone. Baker threw it to anybody. Luckily, it ended up with the white jerseys. McCarthy has it.
McCarthy trying to direct traffic. Good pass to Mendez.
Mendez from the wing, bangs it home.
That's what I'm talking about, this duo. Bang, bang play.
Yeah, but Gateway playing good defensive basketball, forcing BCC to take shots late into the shot clock. Mendez nailed it, though. Oh, underneath. That's a loose basketball. Bad turnover there. Going the other way, Pope.
Pope flying. He gets contact, so fouls. He's going to go to the line. Foul on.
That's going to be on Sauricio.
Yep. Number 22, Rudy
Sauricio. Sauricio related to Whitey Bulger or what? Tall for an Italian, 6'3".
So Baker out, Mercado in.
So BCC with more speed out there now, more athleticism. Baker comes out. Not that he's not athletic, but a bunch of different wing scorers out there now for BCC. Deep three by Newman. Sinks it. Finds the bottom of the drain. Three threes for him. Holy crap.
Well, McCarthy almost lost it, then did lose it.
He lost it. Exactly. He almost lost it, then did lose it.
Evans Antone's coming out, and he's going to be replaced by Roger Hamlet.
Can we not hear ourselves again? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Can you hear me?
I don't think so. There we go. Who was that with the score? Was that number 20? Was that Trevin Arstam?
I think it was.
In the corner, Jose. No, can't get it. Went off Jernigan.
You were getting so ready to call that.
I was. I was ready to put it down. I felt like I had to make up for it. They get inside to Kamara. Loses it out of bounds. They're going to say it's blue ball, though. I guess it's off Mercado?
I don't know. I could have sworn that was going out on Gateway the whole time.
Yeah, number 50, Emmanuel Kamara, fumbled and doubled with that thing. And regardless, in the game now is number 24, Trevin Arstam. Jumper is good. Who was that?
I believe that was Roger Hamlet.
Roger Hamlet.
Roger that.
Roger that. 19-9. Wow. There's Pope. Pope thought about it. They collapsed on him early. Pope. Driving baseline, going up, lays it up.
Tipped up, no good. He's like looking like a volleyball game.
Yes, it does. It was like tip, 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 tip. Kevin Desire is going to come in. He's going to come in for Jernigan.
This is what we talked about. We love our bench, you know. It's good that we have as many subs as we can.
Well, they have a very deep bench. They got guys that can play. That missed by McCarthy. BCC struggling on the offensive end. Gateway playing good defense, too, though. That's a deep three by Newman. Front rims it. Rebounded by McCarthy.
He lands in his hands.
Yeah, he got overzealous with that one. Nice lob in. Desire's going to step out of bounds, though. Or did he get pushed?
I think they're saying he got pushed. Yep, it's a foul on Isaiah Stratford.
And they're saying Stratford pushed him. That's why he went out of bounds. So it's going to be a foul.
So Pope's going to inbound it.
Five fouls by the guest.
None by the Lions. None by the
Turnaround
Bayhawks.
Turnaround desire. Yeah, zero by the Bayhawks. Desire with two, 19-11.
Oh, Newman able to get out of there.
And they're going to say he went out of bounds. Trevor Arstom.
Isaiah Stratford almost ended up in the lap of some of the Bayhawks faithful.
A couple subs out there now for the Lions. One of them is number 20, Isaiah Stratford, as you said. Number 50 in the middle, Emmanuel Kamara. Oh, knocked away by
Speaking
Kamara.
Speaking of
I feel like you're going to say Kamala.
Kamala.
The Ugandan giant. Ooh, Mendes with the up fake. Quick jumper from the elbow. No good. And they're going to call
Mercado.
Yeah, they're going to call a foul away from the ball. Loose ball foul is going to be on Jose Mercado. And that's the first foul for BCC. Halfway through the second first half, I'm sorry. BCC loves that half-court trap. Trap in the corner, three-pointer, no good by Stratford. Rebounded by Kamara, puts it up and in. Pushing it back the other way.
Yeah, Kamara stands at 6 foot one. He had great reach to get the rebound.
No good. Going the other way is Arstom. He's going to hold it up, though. Then he pushes. Lost control of it, but I believe he's going to go to the line. He got fouled on the layup attempt. This game is kind of sketchy playing so far.
Definitely. It's been kind of an uncharacteristic game.
It sure has.
You know, Gateway's been playing great defense. We haven't seen the Bayhawks shut down like this in a long time.
Yeah, Gateway's very quick. They're very quick to the basketball. They're very quick to shut off passing lanes. Very quick to get to the baseline. They're trapping. They're causing a lot of confusion. Mm. BCC doesn't know how to attack this this defense right now.
Yeah, you've seen some of these players for BCC. You know, they make these plays fairly routine most other games, so they're just getting shut down.
It's the zone. The zone is being very effective right now. 2-3 zone. And they're coming out to challenge those outside shots, and there it is, another turnover. The bounce pass to Stratford, lays it in, and the foul is good.
And the steal from, I believe that was Hamlet.
That's Hamlet. That's your boy. I'm waiting for it.
You can't put me on the spot.
I know.
I need time.
I can hear you.
I need time to write these things. You can hear me now? Okay, good.
I think I've been able to hear you. It's been so long since I could hear you that I don't even know what hearing you is like.
You just tune me out.
Exactly.
It becomes the Dave Cardoza show.
Oh, stop it. So sensitive. Stratford puts it up. The floater's no good. Rebounded by Jernigan.
Well, it's like Megan Parrish's dad say. It's like, you know, Dave, you're doing such a great job. Yeah, you do okay, too.
That's the way it goes. Oh, nice up and under.
I thought he was going to slam it.
It was a nice look by Jernigan.
Oh, my God. Someone greased the ball before the game?
Yeah. The ball is like a bar of soap. The floor is slippery. Oh, stepping back. Newman. No, can't get it to go. That was pretty. Goes back and fights for the ball.
This is crazy.
Great hustle by Newman. Newman getting back there like a free safety.
Pope was looking for the wide open pass and just didn't get it. Newman came out of nowhere to steal it.
More tips. Nice pass by Arstom.
Oh,
blocked by Jernigan. But they're going to call a foul, and Kamara's going to go to the line. BCC during the warm-ups, Craig, They were hyped up. They were inspired. They were slamming the ball down. They looked like they look fired up. But they've really had a lot of wind taken out of their sails here in the first half.
And still a lot of game left. They're no way out of this. But Gateway's just been playing so good defense, really just shutting them down.
Yeah, because I feel like Gateway really hasn't been playing well offensively. I mean, Newman has, you know, basically half their points. Kamara sinks both free throws is 26-11, 15-point lead.
It's not necessarily Gateway's offense. It is just their defense.
Exactly. Jernigan, cross-court pass to Mendez. Mendez flying in. He's got his shot altered and tipped by Kamara.
That went off the side of the backboard.
Yeah. Oh, Kamara's there at the other end. The pass by Arstom. Kamara doing it on both ends of the floor. BCC needs a timeout. Call a timeout, Coach D. 28-11.
You talk about Alec Newman having like half their points. Emmanuel Kamara's been pretty big these last couple plays.
He really has.
You know, on both ends, like you said, getting blocks, getting rebounds, and getting drives.
And he's a sophomore coming out the bench, 6'1". He looks like he's
playing center.
He seems and he plays like a lot taller than when he stands at it. 6'1", he seems like he's a little bit taller than that, but he's lengthy, he's rangy, and he's athletic.
That's actually what I was thinking. I was like, you know, he's playing as our center and getting good rebounds, getting good reaches, and then you look, he is only 6'1".
But it seems like he's 6'3", 6'4", or something like that.
Yeah, exactly.
Anyways, BCC going to head into tournament play as either the number one or number two seed. They're going to head up into the MCCAC, the Massachusetts State Tournament. I might not even have it right. Who knows? Something like that. The MCCAC State Tournament. And then that's going to be on February 24th and 25th, I believe. And then following that, on March 4th and March 5th, is going to be the Region 21 tournament, and again, which they should be the number one and number two seed, and that's going to decide if they're going to make it to the Nationals, which is in Minnesota, as we know. So, in neither of those tournaments, BCC has never been to the national tournament. They never won either of those tournaments, so BCC looking to make some history. If any team is going to do it, it's going to be this team right here.
Yep, this team definitely looking to win a ring.
Yeah, I want a ring.
We got rings.
Mendez going up against that zone. Knocked away. Mercado loses it. Stratford was there. Knocked it away, 28-11. And BCC is just all out of sorts today.
They just can't work around this defense.
Yeah, and Armani Baker not doing too much, and that's uncharacteristic. Ooh, Newman so good with the basketball. Deep three. No good. Mercado pushing it back the other way. Doesn't have the numbers, but he gets it underneath to Pope, and Pope loses it. Pope lost it. Again, that was a good defensive play. Stratford, somehow that gets to Kamara, and he had it blocked.
That's what we talk about. He's playing like he's bigger than he is.
Yeah, blocked by Mercado. On the shot clock. Again, BCC has to shoot this at the end. Oh, nice pass by Baker.
No, Jernigan still
has it. But he can't do nothing with it, though. Mendez drops it up to Baker. Inside. No good. Baker can't get the second chance opportunity in the open court. Armstrong, start a step. Puts it up on the glass. No good. Both teams are playing not too good on the offensive end. Sloppy play. And they're going to call, they're going to say it's a wet.
They're calling a foul on Stratford.
They're going to call a blocking foul on Stratford. Another wet spot, too, as well. 28-11. 5:44 in the first half, Greg. What the heck is going on? BCC, usually you see BCC flying out the gate. Guys like McCarthy, Quincy Pope, Mercado, they're draining threes. They're able to slash and dash. Their fast break is getting going. Their defense is permeating points. Today, they're just stalled by this blue attack over here.
Yeah, they just can't get the ball rolling. That's really the main problem. Just every time they go for something, they get shut down. They go for drives. They got four people on them. They go for shots. They got really tight coverage on them. And then whenever they're trying to pass, you just got a blue shirt coming in to steal it.
I was going to say, they usually get a lot of open looks, don't they?
Yeah.
They're not getting any open looks today either.
No. The zone is deadly.
The zone is working. Could this be the blueprint, literally? That blueprint defense, that blueprint 2-3 zone.
Maybe.
Mendez trying to work that zone. Gets it in the corner. There's an open three. That's no good, though. They're not hitting the open shots that they're that they're getting. Pope missed that one.
BCC has been known to be an offensive team, and you shut down that offense, not much else you can do.
One of the higher score teams in Region 21. They definitely put up in the mid-80s towards the 90s. They can't get it going today. Only 11 points at home with 5 minutes, approaching 5 minutes to play in the first half, and they only have 11 points. That is unheard of. Driving to the hole. Stepping back is Newman. Jumper, no good.
Kamara almost put up a putback.
Tell you what, Gateway not playing much better. They have 28 points. What is that? That's nothing.
That was a very low-scoring game.
Very low-scoring game. It's just the defense by the Lions causing fits. Causing a lot of fits right now.
And more wet spots.
Inbound in the basketball is Corey Corbin. Corey Corbin's number 3 with the headband.
It's a cool name to have.
Yeah. He's in the game now.
Not as cool as Baron Corbin, though.
Yeah. Don't get me started.
Well, you a Corbin fan or not?
No. Really? I don't know. I don't know how he gets all these like main event opportunities.
He's in the chamber.
Stupid. Just because he's big.
Yeah.
Sloppy big, too. Oh, the alley-oop. That's going to way off.
No.
Too high.
So that fooled me, too. I didn't see that coming.
And that is going to be a one-on-one. That's going to be the seventh team foul on the Lions here in the first half. And finally, BCC is going to have a chance to shoot some foul shots here down the stretch here in the first half. 4:38 to play.
Anything to put some points on the board.
That's the only way. Mendes bends the knees. Can't get it to go, but then it's tipped in by Jernigan. Boy, they got lucky there.
Let's do the John Madden way of saying of how to win, score more points than the other team.
Yeah. There it is. Mendes buzzing like a bee, going to the rack, and he gets hacked. Gets hacked by Corbin. Still getting shots because they're in the penalty. They're in the one-on-one penalty, so.
Yep.
Coach Delalue wanted it to be on the shot. It would be two shots, but still going to be shots, one-on-one. So if he makes this shot, moot point, but if he misses.
Mendes approaches the line, not looking 100% after that hit.
And he misses it. Rebounded by Kamara. Only 13 points in the first half. BCC needs to come out in the second half with that trap, with the pressing defense, cause turnovers, get some momentum.
And speaking of turnovers, got some up and down action from Gateway.
Well, dude, that was a good defensive play by Pope. Going back in BCC's direction.
Arstrom out, Cericho in.
Yeah, BCC's offense kind of stagnant right now, not moving. We don't see the motion we usually see from them. Going underneath this Jernigan, that's a bad pass.
Yep, threw it right to Newman.
Going back the other way, Newman.
Newman showing some handles.
Newman showing that shuffle. Cericho driving to his left, gets it blocked by Mercado.
Mercado getting some good blocks
but
in this
game. But here's Kamara going up against Mercado, puts it right in his eye.
Yeah, I was just saying Mercado some good blocks. Couldn't block Kamara on that one.
Not on that one. Mercado with a good effort, but Kamara got the ball and drove it right back at him, the sophomore. Goodness gracious, 30-13. And we're going to take a timeout here on the floor here at Bishop Conley High School in good old Fall River. These are two teams that could face each other come playoff time. Come tournament time, these two teams could face each other. Region 21. Going to be a fun month, my friend.
Playoff basketball, no better words. Except for the two greatest words in sports, Game 7.
Game 7?
Yeah, that's what everyone says, Game 7. Best two words. Game 7, like in World Series or Stanley Cup or NBA Finals.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I get you, man. Game 7. This is single elimination play, though.
But in the pros. I knew
Rob Del Lue like Tom Brady.
Is he saying, let's go?
Like, let's go.
Let's go. They just need someone to make a Julian Edelman-esque catch, even though it wouldn't matter if it hit the ground or not.
You're in the wrong sport, man.
Yeah, I'm still thinking about that. I watch that catch every night before I go to sleep now. It helps me sleep.
You want Julian Edelman to rock you to sleep.
I mean,
cradle you in his bosom.
No, I just want to see him catch a football like that again.
It'll never happen again.
Hey, Julian Edelman's my boy.
Definitely a cool dude.
He's the guy you always want mic'd up.
PCC matching up, man. Four corners offense over here by Gateway. Opening up for Newman. Newman picks up his dribble now. That's what PCC wants you to do. Kicking it back out. Newman's going to tee it up. You know he loves that way short. Mercado bringing it back the other way. PCC is just... Jernigan, rebounded as Mercado, trying to tip it as Baker, and they'll get another shot clock.
This game is going a million miles an hour.
It is. It's unbelievable. BCC is just...
We're going to have trouble keeping track of the turnovers.
Pope, cross court. Mercado, that's his shot for three. No good.
Mercado hasn't had his three-point stroke this game.
No threes today for Mercado. Usually he's coming out stroking. 2.5 minutes to play. Down 17.
Call a foul away from the ball.
Not sure what he did. I didn't think that he used his forearm, pushing off.
Either way, Bayhawks ball.
Couldn't have been a foul, though, because that should be. Couldn't have been a foul, though, because that would have been shots. I'm not sure what they called.
I don't know. They were holding up the 22 like he fouled them.
And that's what they have out there.
Now they're having trouble with the shot clock, I think. There's all sorts of problems happening in this game.
I think the cathedral's coming apart.
Now the shot clock's gone. Now they set it.
Problems with the shot clock, the floor, everything. Here's Mendes. Gateway still in that 2-3 zone, going strong.
It's been working so far.
Yeah, BCC hasn't been able to figure it out. Another turnover.
There's more turnovers than a sleepless night.
Evans Antoine now in the game with the goggles, number 32. He's got the basketball right now.
Good luck, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Yeah. Pretty cool haircuts by Gateway. Five on the shot clock, driving. Ceruccio, nice, gets it inside of Kamara, and they're going to call offensive. And who else to pick it up is Armani Baker, who does the grunt work. And I guess you don't get foul shots when it's a charge or a foul away from the ball like that, because that's 10 team fouls now on the Lions here in the first half, and it should be. Double bonus.
Maybe Rudy Ceruccio just gets a pass. Whenever he fouls someone, they don't have to go take shots.
Exactly.
It's the second time it's
him. I guess so.
It's the second time it's him.
Well, his last name is Ceruccio. We know what that means. Someone's going to get whacked.
You going to call a hit on our team?
Keith is going to get so many phone calls on these broadcasts. Oh, my goodness. Jernigan in the paint, puts it above the glass strong, and that's what you need to see. Jernigan flashing high and then dropping it down low.
Feels like forever we've seen a Bayhawks score.
It's been forever that we've seen a legitimate field goal. Evans Antoine from the wing, no good. Tipped. Baker couldn't get a hold of it. Going up and almost slamming it was Roger Hamlet.
Just kind of teasing it, ended up putting it up. Less than a minute left in the half.
Mendes, ooh, he traveled.
Yep, big time.
Couldn't keep his wits about him. He travels. Try to find his way into the lane.
This is crazy how low this score is.
BCC hasn't had that many field goals.
I think it's the lowest we've ever seen it.
I think we're going to see a lot more scoring in the second half. It's got to be, right?
Definitely. Got to change it up. Hopefully when he talks to them during halftime, they can figure out a new strategy, change things up.
10 on the shot clock.
Good coverage on
Chase
Newman.
And Newman, yeah, they got double guys on. They got two guys on Newman going cross court. The three-pointer,
no good.
BCC will hold for the final shot, I believe. Shot clock is off. 10 on the game clock.
Yeah, Mendez taking his time.
Yep, Gateway still in that zone. BCC looking to score before the half. Mendez falls away. Three-pointer, no good, and that's going to be the end of the first half. And what a bad first half it was for BCC as they trail 32-15 at the half here at Bishop Connolly High School. Welcome back, everybody, to Bishop Connolly High School here in Fall River, Massachusetts, where the Bristol Community College Bayhawks trail the Gateway Community College Lions 32-15. BCC having trouble against the Lions zone, not doing very well. Coach Rob Delalue hopefully can pick up his team here. As they huddle up here, and we get ready to start the second half, I'm David Cardoz. Alongside with me is the Portuguese Cowboy, Craig Salvador, and DP on the camera work here on a Saturday afternoon. You're watching this on FR Media, Bristol Bayhawks basketball. And Craig, what does BCC need to do to get back into this game?
Have a new offensive strategy, because they've just been shut down completely on offense from this Gateway defense.
How about going back to that press? How about trapping and pressing and using that in-your-face defense that we see from them? They haven't used that press. They haven't used that trap at all. If BCC is going to get back into this game, Craig, they need to play better defense, because their defense is their offense.
This is true.
And just like
turnover.
That, yeah, quick turnover. That's how you want to start the half. Coming out. BCC plays better when they're playing fast. Driving and dishing it somehow to Jernigan. No good. Big rebound there.
It's Roger
Hamlet. Evans Antoine driving the lane. And they're going to call that foul, a hand check on Marcus McCarthy.
Yeah, McCarthy's first of the game, first of this half.
McCarthy out there, number 23, number 1, Danny Mendez, number 13, Quincy Pope, number 14, Armani Baker, and number 4, Desmond Jernigan, all out there for the Bayhawks.
We don't even have a roster sheet, folks. He just knows that.
That's right. Three-pointer, Newman coming off, tipped up, loose ball.
Out of way.
Who's going to get it? And referee points right at number 21, Roger Hamlet.
So I don't think that's what Jernigan meant to do, but it sure worked.
Hey, they got the basketball. That all that counts.
Yeah, just try to save it and just nick it off your opponent.
Coach Rob Delalue was very frustrated, as you can imagine, at the end of that first half.
This game is definitely not going the way the Bayhawks had hoped.
No, I don't think BCC plays particularly well when they're slowed down like they are being right now when they're in a half-court setting. McCarthy got nothing. Mendez takes it, goes into the lane, somehow gets it up. Not up high enough. Loose ball. Does anybody want the basketball right now?
I don't think so.
McCarthy going up, floats it, no good. BCC can't get anything to land. You've got to be.
Ball's loose again.
And they're going to be another loose ball, and this is going to be Bristol's.
There's about five things happening at the same time.
Yeah, it's going to be Bristol basketball, though. Bristol, here's Pope. Pope lobs it in. I can't get it over Kamara. I mean, I don't know what he was thinking there. Kamara with a good defensive play. Hamlet to Kamara. Turnaround jumper. Fall away. No good. Both teams shooting poorly from the field.
No, that was a pretty play, too, but Kamara couldn't get it to fall.
If I was estimating, I would say Gateway shooting like 32% from the field. And you got BCC shooting like 16% from the field right now.
I was thinking 17, but close 16, enough.
16, 17%. It's not high.
That's
trust
not
me.
Good. Oh, risky pass.
Loose basketball. This is how you get a score for BCC. McCarthy to the hole.
Lost
no
it.
Good. Camaro there for another rebound.
No, McCarthy had a late jump on it. He had to get over his opponent to get the ball.
Gateway does a good job of recovering. Evans Antoine from the top, no good, way off.
Couldn't see through the goggles.
Neither team could score in the first couple minutes. Mendes in the lane, and he's going to get fouled. And he'll be going to the line for two. It's going to be another foul. They're going to call another push off on Sericio.
And Mendes has been taking some bumps this game.
He is. Mendes, he's a fighter. He's a speedster. He gets into the lane, but boy, he's been getting eaten up down there once he gets there.
Now he's got to put some points on the board.
And Craig Sericio finally gets a foul that someone's going to go to the line for.
Well, he's in foul trouble now. He's got four.
Yeah, he's got four.
It's been kind of quiet, too. You haven't really seen much of him, but when you do, it's pretty much only been fouls.
No, and he hasn't scored that much since early on. Trevor Armstrong is in for him. And Mendes sinks both free throws, so the first couple points are on the board for BCC. Trailing by 15. Second half action. From Fall River. Crossing over is Newman. Up and under, a nice play. They're going to call steps.
Yep.
Too many steps.
Yep, kind of a late call. I was thinking it, but then they were able to say it. McCarthy trying to direct traffic.
Yeah, Gateway with that, yep. Pope gets it to Baker on that. Finally gets that shot where he likes it. It gets blocked.
Got stuffed by Kamara.
And that's going to be Gateway ball this time. They're going to say it's blue ball, and it is. Almost 3 minutes have elapsed, Craig. And neither team has a field goal. Neither team has a shot from the field. Only free throws, only points scored by BCC.
It's just been ugly offense this entire game.
Newman's going to keep that dribble.
Foul on Kamara, away from the ball.
And I tell you what, Gateway's coach is getting frustrated over there with these fouls away from the ball. You have possession of the basketball, and then you give it away. And it's going to be BCC basketball. 3 minutes have elapsed. Not much is going on. A lot of confusion in this game. Now they're going to advance the ball to half court. Okay. Mendes, deep three. High arc,
no good.
Rebounded by Schrodinger, goes up and gets it. And maybe that's what BCC needs to try to get back into this game.
They're definitely pumped, and that can do a lot for their team. And they got a man. Gateway's got a man down.
Yeah, Gateway does have a man down, and he's not moved.
No, this does not look good.
He is not moved.
He's starting to move his foot a little bit.
Well, that's good to see at least. But he went down.
No, it didn't. He's hurt, not sure what.
Looks like he's holding the ankle now.
I thought with how he was down, I thought he might have hit his head, might have hit butted heads with Jernigan on the play.
Yeah, he went down and out. So I guess we'll keep it here. 32-19 now. That was a big possession. Big shot by Jernigan, who's going to go to the line, and he's going to come to his feet. That's Roger Hamlet. And he's walking with a limp. Not sure what his status is going to be, but he's one of their better players. But he is walking off the court, being helped off with a trainer. But he is walking very gingerly on that right leg, I presume. It looks like. And he'll go to the bench. He'll be worked on, but Jernigan's going to go to the line. And I'm not sure what's going on. There's a lot of confusion in this game. They got to come out for shots, for free throw shots. Okay, so maybe that's the shot that can get this team back into the game. Because I'll tell you what, Gateway not playing. They don't have a guy right now that's stepping up and making shots for them. Really, it's just their defense. And that's a three-point play that maybe can propel this team And now here comes that full court press.
Yeah, Baker had the block, but right out of bounds. It's only a 12-point game.
Still, Gateway hasn't faced a press like this. They haven't faced a press like this from Bristol yet. Mendez on the ball. BCC matching up, man, full length of the court. They inbound the basketball. If anybody can break the press, it's this kid. He's got a good handle. BCC all over Gateway now, man-to-man. Defense is turned up now. Time to turn the volume up. Three-pointer in the corner. Evans Antoine,
no good.
Rebounded, lost the ball. Pope lost the ball out of bounds.
This has been kind of happening to the Bayhawks this game. They're getting attempts, but they just keep losing it.
Yeah,
it was a tough play,
but
still.
They keep tipping the ball up. Can't get a hold of it. Got to go up there and grab it. Crossing over is Newman. Getting into the lane. Going right. It's going to be a – and they're going to call a charge.
Yep, it's Jernigan again.
Jernigan, he's good for that.
Now Jernigan walking with a limp.
Yeah, he's walking a limp. That's what happens when you take those full-on collisions right there, which Jernigan did. 32-20. Gateway with the lead, but lots of time left, and BCC got the basketball. So four team fouls on the Lions.
Only two for the Bayhawks.
Yeah, and we've seen the Lions get into foul trouble last half. They were in the double. BCC got into the double bonus. BCC has to figure out a way to score. Who's going to score for BCC? Jernigan at the top, dumps it down to Baker. And, man, he's getting hammered down there. BCC is getting hammered down there.
Fouls on Antone. Yeah, Baker went up for that and just got swatted right out of him.
Yeah. And
not even swatted. It was like uppercutted.
Undertaker style.
And I mean, maybe that's what can stop the defense, just a two-stone pile driver to Gateway.
Or the equivalent of. And Baker gets a Bayhawks bounce there.
I was just going to say that. Got
Baker's undersized. You know, he plays big, plays a lot of heart, a lot of determination, and he plays above what his height is, about 6'1", 6'2". But he's getting hammered down there today. Nails both free throws. It's a 10-point lead. Gateway hasn't scored yet. Losing the ball, but Armstrong.
Oh, Mendez almost got it.
And Mendez is going to get a foul.
No, it's going to be on Jernigan. So just the third team foul for the Bayhawks.
Three-point shot, Newman.
Can't get it. Newman going cold.
Yeah, Gateway's cold. He was cold. He had a few three-pointers. He had three three-pointers in the first half. Mendez. Well, they're all over that. And Mendez usually getting that corner shot. They're collapsing on that shot. Jernigan down low. Baker going strong, and he gets it.
And that's what they got to do, quick passing and scoring.
Finally, Baker. They send Jernigan up high. They get it down low to a cunning Baker. Going baseline. Slams it. Puts it up off the backboard.
The Bayhawks finally making this point differential to single digits.
And it was 32-15, opening the second half on a 9-0 run. Trying to make it a 10-0 run. Baker for the old-fashioned three-point play. And he does it. 10-0 run to start the first half. Now Gateway has to figure out this press. Here's Antoine bringing it up. Bring it up all the way. Bounce pass inside. Oh, what a block,
by Pope. He has just been excommunicated from the church by Pope.
Jumper in the lane. It's good. On the other end.
Now this is the Bayhawks team we know and have seen all season.
Gateway going to need a basket. They're going to need a basket. Scoreless so far. Picking his dribble up again. That's not wise.
Newman had no idea what to do.
Yeah, he shouldn't pick up his dribble. They're collapsing on Walker. They get inside of Kamara, and there's going to be a foul on the entry pass. And they're going to call that foul on The foul's going to be on Danny Mendes.
Yep, number two for number one.
Kamara's in the corner.
Traveled.
He traveled.
Oh, he does not like that call.
Going to use that pivot foot. Can't do a curtsy.
This is what the Bayhawks need, another quick turnover.
Yeah. Total a tale of different halves. Ooh, McCarthy thought about it. Mendes. Ooh, driving the lane. Tried to get it into Jernigan. Good thought.
Well, Gateway almost knocked it in their own basket.
Yeah, they almost did. Good defensive play. Here's Armstrong. Armstrong to a cutting.
Well, he's still got it.
Oh, goodness. Jumper up and in.
That's Burks. I don't know how he came away with
Lewis Burks coming out of nowhere. Ugly shot, but it bounces in. And that's the first basket. Almost 6 minutes in, that's the first basket. The first points by the Lions. Short jumper. It's good. Poke from about 17 feet. Evans Antoine. We might have a game, my friend. Burks dribbling and bibbling. Falls away into the corner.
It's another blocked by Jernigan.
Blocked by Jernigan. BCC with the blocks. Pope almost lost it. Good job by Pope to get it back out to McCarthy.
Yeah, Newman was giving chase, but McCarthy caught it.
Yeah, McCarthy's doing a good job possessing that one. 10 on the shot clock. Cross court. Mendes, deep three.
Nope.
Nothing doing. Rebounded by Kamara. BCC still on a 14-2 run to open up the second half here in the first 7 minutes. Three-pointer by Newman. Referee puts his hands up. They call a three, and then they call a technical on him. What did he do?
I don't know. I think they're saying maybe he bumped Pope or something. I don't know.
Tell you what, these referees here in the Region 21, they don't play. I didn't see anything.
I
don't know
either.
What the heck that is.
We're right
maybe
here.
Maybe he said something or?
Maybe.
The jester?
Mendes sinks it.
That was, either way, that was a big three by Newman. Stop the bleeding because BCC was coming right down their throat on a 14-2 run, and that three stopped that run.
So that does beg the question, what did Newman do?
Well, earlier, if you remember, Craig, the referee went up to him and said, if you do that again, if you do that gesture again or whatever he did, you're going to get a technical foul. And I think the referee just got tired of it. Something that he did, something that he said, it could be like taunting or something, some kind of whatever.
Maybe. Refs don't forget.
This era that you all live in now is soft.
Mm-hmm. Don't blame me. I'm not the one doing it.
You're the face of it.
I'm the face of it, yeah.
13. No, you're not the face of it.
Yeah.
No, back out. Mendes swings it to Pope.
I was going to say, I'm not good enough to be the face of it.
13 on the shot clock. Oh, that Ooh. Pass picked off.
It's Hamlet back in the game.
Yep, Hamlet back in the game. Wow. That foot ain't bothering him now. Newman gets it to Hamlet.
That was a good pass.
Hamlet puts it up. Tipped by Kamara. Up to get it is Mercado.
Been seeing Mercado better on defense than offense this game.
Yeah. Yeah, he's definitely had his hands in it. Mercado going baseline. Jumper no good. Rebounded by Jernigan.
He's going to get a foul.
And he's going to get the foul. He's going to go to the line. And BCC putting their hard hat on now, getting to work. Getting to work like Rihanna. 37-31. 6-point lead. Just like that. It was a 32-15 lead at the half. A 17-point lead been cut down to 6. And Jernigan, I don't know. I thought he rushed that one.
Maybe.
Or he thought about it too much. Maybe he didn't rush it, but it was just like.
It's got a lot, like, big lofty release.
Yeah.
We don't see. Jernigan's not one of the shooters this team.
Yeah, but he usually does an okay job with free throws, and that second free throw was worse than the first one. Had a chance to cut the lead within 4. A lot of time left, though. BCC has all the momentum in the world here at home.
And Kevin Desire is coming in for Jernigan.
That's your boy. Here it is. Man to man. Newman, guarded by Pope. Newman crossing over, around the back. Again, Pope. He always picks up that dribble, and that's a big mistake.
Yeah, Pope doing a great job staying on him.
He's got a good dribble. He's got good handle. He's got good speed.
Just doesn't know what to do with it.
Yeah, but other players for Gateway, they got to come to the ball. They got to move around, too. They're not doing that. They're leaving him on an island, but still, he should pick up his dribble. He's out there in the backcourt dribbling, and then he picks up a dribble, and then he's in trouble. It makes no sense. For BCC, they're playing with all the momentum now. Look at this guy. Instagram hero.
Snapchat, actually.
Snap face.
Snap face.
Face.
Because now you're acting like the face of your generation.
Insta space.
Check me out on MySpace.
My face.
MySpace is.
My face, your face.
MySpace
our face.
Is deader than the 76ers playoff chance.
Do they even still have a site?
No. What, MySpace?
Yeah. Is that even like?
Probably. It's probably there. I don't doubt anyone's on it.
Kicking it back out.
Some good give and go action.
Evans Antoine getting a lot of time, and he has done a world of nothing. Evans Antoine. What in the world just happened?
It like passed it. It nicked off of Gateway, and it was going to roll out of bounds, but Desire picked it up, and I don't know what they're calling for it. It never went out of bounds.
Nonetheless, it's going to be Lions basketball.
Which I don't know how that's working, as there wasn't a foul on the play. And again, it wasn't going out of bounds. Desire picked it up before it had a chance to go out.
Either way, the commotion lies. Referee's huddling up now.
I think they're calling that it went out of bounds.
They looked at it on the instant replay.
Yeah, I think they're saying that Desire picked it up out of bounds, but that didn't happen, so.
It's going to stay here. Gateway basketball. They'll dump it in. And they put it up. Oh, almost at the shot clock. Hamlin missed it. Going back the other hand. Jose to Pope. Lays it in.
Beautiful play.
4-point lead.
Beautiful play.
Getting noisy.
Yeah, you know we like to get loud in the cathedral.
And they're going to call a push.
It's on Pope. It's going to stay down here.
And the Lions have 18 fouls on their end. Only 4 for BCC. 5 for BCC now. And it's going to be a 2-shot foul. So as BCC tries to inch closer, they commit the foul there.
Jernigan and McCarthy looking to get back in this game.
Well, interesting to see who they go in for.
It'll be Armani Baker and Danny Mendez.
Baker and Mendez will
makes
go
sense.
Out.
You know, these players mirror each other, so it makes sense that's who they're going out for. You know, Mendez for McCarthy, Baker for Jernigan, or Jernigan for Baker.
I like Baker on the inside, but.
Dave receiving a phone call. So McCarthy has it. So I'll call it. I guess they're not following
well,
the
BCC
play call.
Well, BCC wanted to get into something. Coach Rob Del Lue was calling something, and I guess they weren't entirely sure. Coach Del Lue calls them in, calls a timeout. He's like, you guys don't know the plays. We'll see if they can get it together. 37-33. Either way, Craig, we get ourselves a basketball game. Thank God. I was over here falling asleep.
I had a large iced coffee from Dunk's, so I'm still awake.
Yep.
I got to go to work after this, so.
Oh, that stinks.
Yeah. Got to make that money, all that gas I have to buy to get here.
Oh, you do live far away.
I live half an hour away, so.
Oh, I thought you lived here in the river.
No, I don't. I was born here, but I don't live here. You know. Still,
I guess you were right, Denise.
Well, what'd Denise say? Is she talking crap about me?
No. She just said that you probably live somewhere else.
Yeah. I drive a lot. So we just got to kick back, listen to music, and right now just watch some Bayhawks basketball.
37 to 33.
I should be a spokesperson for something.
Mercado for three. Can't get it to go.
He's yet to hit a three in this
game. Oh, he's cold from out there. Hasn't hit a three today. 11 minutes to play. Evans Antoine driving all the way. Ball way up off the glass. Kamara falling away. The putback is no good.
Desire
rebounded
with the rebound.
By Desire.
That was crazy play.
Evans Antoine. I say Evans Antoine because he's out there, but he's not. I don't know what the heck he's doing out there.
Good
Jernigan. Oh, that was a nice pass. Back out. They'll swing it. Boy, BC Gateway zone is. Oh, my goodness.
Great play, Marcus McCarthy.
How did he get that? Floater at the buzzer at the shot clock. I was just about to say Gateway zone is just so active. Antoine backed up into the corner. 2-point lead now.
Antoine
approaching the halfway point. Knocked away by Desire. Mercado couldn't get there.
Yeah, Mercado had the speed advantage, but
and
wasn't
a bounce pass. He'll get it inside to Hamlet. Hamlet scores on that one, 39 to 35. Under 10 minutes to play now. Got ourselves a ball game. Oh! Desire tried to get the behind-the-back pass. McCarthy misses. Desire to try to put it back. No good. Hammond with a rebound. Puts it out there for Newman.
Oh, Desire
Newman
coming full head of speed.
Still pump it in! Unbelievable!
Alex
Desire
Newman
goes flying.
Desire can't believe it.
Desire thought he was going to get him some basketball, and Newman with the double pump. Unbelievable move. That's going to be on SportsCenter. Jose, no good. Rebounded by Jernigan.
Desire gives it right
and Newman,
to Newman.
Spinning in the open court. Gets his pass tipped away.
What's going to stay down?
And in come Baker and Mendez again, in for Desire and Mercado. Mercado just not having his best offensive game today. Hasn't hit from the outside at all today. Only 35 points for the Bayhawks in this one. Unbelievable with 9 minutes to play.
I know we usually see them double this at this point.
Yeah, we usually see them about in the 50s right now, the 60s. 9:02 left to play. Still, BCC hanging right in there. They've had a hell of a run. 20 to outscoring Gateway 20 to 7. I'm sorry, 20 to 9. But Gateway still continue to fight them off. Just when BCC climbs all the way back in it, it was 37 to 35, and then Gateway with a couple baskets to kind of push them off. And what a layup in the open floor by Alex J. Newman. That was a hell. How the hell did that ball not get shoved down his throat?
I don't know.
Desire
was out for blood. The much bigger man just going up to try to swat it. And like you said, that double pump action.
He goes up with that. It's getting knocked out the box. The fact that he had the wherewithal to know where Desire was at, fake him up and with a double pump. He was able to stay in the air long enough for Desire to go by him and double pump it underneath and lay that basketball in the open floor, flying like a bat out of hell. Excellent play by Alex J. Newman, freshman guard from New Haven, Connecticut. Inbound underneath their own basket. Newman's momentum brought him forward. They fell out of bounds and lost that one. 9 minutes flat to go. Here's McCarthy. McCarthy with the basketball, crossing over. Dribbles into the lane. Floater, no good.
No one really
Newman coming away with it. Lost it. McCarthy with the hustle and the good defensive play. We need laser sharp focus here, fellas. Mendez, baseline. I'm sorry, Baker. And Baker's going to go to the line for two.
Foul on Kamara.
Yeah, foul on Kamara, I think, on the shot. He's got three. That was weird.
Is there a hole in the net?
There must be a hole. Reminds me of playing down the playground back in the day. You get like that little hole in the net. Ball goes flying. And they're going to call a volley. Violation on White. Violation on Bristol. Second free throw was discounted.
Now that can be costly.
No, they got a lot of time left.
They lose by 1 point.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to call you that. I'm going to call you on that.
All right.
You have to say that I was right.
Okay, no problem. I'll say I was wrong. I was...
You were what?
Here's Evans Antoine with the basketball. BCC still in that man.
I almost didn't recognize him. He's not wearing his
bad
goggles
anymore. Bad pass by Walker.
Evans Antoine not wearing his goggles anymore.
Yeah, that's probably why. Laying it on the other end is Mendez. I just called Evans Antoine Walker. I meant Evans Antoine, not Antoine Walker. Fall away. No good. Another foul? They call another foul on Kamara. And they're going to send Jernigan to the line. 7:58 to play. We're approaching winning time. Just under 8 minutes to play, 41-38. What was a 17-point lead is cut down to three. Jernigan could cut it even more. And he can't do it. If BCC's going to win this game, they got to hit these free throws because they're in the double bonus for the next 8 minutes. Every foul from here on out is going to be two free throws for BCC, every foul that the Lions commit. God, you're right, Craig. He's got that high-rising shot. That ball hit the top of the backboard, I believe.
Yeah, saying no basket.
No basket.
So it stays a three-point game.
Yeah, Jernigan again can't hit his free throws. That could have brought them within one, and they can't do it.
He's been struggling from the line.
41-38, 7:58 to play. Here's A.J. Newman with the basketball. All 5'9" of them, 159 pounds.
Picked up the dribble.
Picked up the triple again, and then it's picked off. Tucci pay for it. Going the other way is Mendez up, and he's going to go to the line.
Hamlet went for the biggest block of his life and got nothing but air.
Yeah, he went for it for sure. Mendez was buzzing like a bee, full steam ahead. He's so quick. He's going to go to the line for two. BCC is going to be shooting a lot of free throws here down the stretch. Trying to complete the comeback. They have a lot of time to do it. And the free throw bounces around and falls through. They're within two now. BCC is one of the highest scoring teams at the conference. One of the highest scoring teams of the country. They could score. They could score. They have a deep team. Gateway, as good as their defense has been, Craig, they haven't really been able to score today anyway. They haven't been there. It's not like they're playing this lights out game. Offensively, they've been shaky as well.
Not a low scoring game for both teams.
Yeah. Oh, the women's game was more points than this. The Gateway Community College women's team scored 72.
So we get the next week, we get the women's team to face our men's team, right?
Oh, jeez. Let's not even go there. Hamlet gives it a 2-point lead, 42-40, 7:36 to play. And again, Gateway still holding off.
Yep, still a one-possession game.
Yes, a one-possession game.
A lot of time left. More shot clock problems.
Shot clock problems.
Yep. The sky is blue, the grass is green, and the shot clock is having problems.
All right, now here we go. Shot clock is set. 20 on the shot clock. They get it to Baker.
Baker looking to give it away.
All over him. He's all over Baker. Going. Driving to the lane. Up and under and in. BCC's within one.
Well, McCarthy almost had that picked off.
Going. Newman. And
an offensive foul on Newman, I think.
No, they didn't. Nope. They did not. I believe that foul's going to be on Baker. It is.
Yep, it is. I was wrong.
It's going to be, yeah, it's going to be on Baker. That's going to be his first. And now, Gateway's in the bonus now. That was going to be on the shot, though. It's going to be a two-shot foul with 7:04 to play. Good crowd on hand. Late afternoon. First shot drops in, 44-42. Both free throws made. BCC keeps climbing to within 1 or 2 points, and then Gateway keeps responding. Got to give them credit. One possession game. Under 7 minutes to play. McCarthy, the floater. It's good. Back to within one. This is the game we want. Seesaw battle now.
What we really want is for BCC to get a lead in this game.
The place will come undone once they do. And
it's a turnover. BCC's ball.
Yeah, turnover. What did they call? Is it 3 seconds? What did they call?
They called something.
Either way, it's a turnover. Bristol's going to get the basketball. 2-3 zone. BCC looking for their first lead of the game.
15 left on the shot clock.
Cross-court pass.
Oh, Pope
wide for three.
Open.
No good. He had a chance to give him the lead and more. Newman all by himself. Loses it out of bounds. I believe it was knocked away by Bristol, but a good defensive play there. I think it was McCarthy.
I think he tried to steal it and just lost it.
No, McCarthy knocked it out of bounds. Here we go. We got a stack. Newman lobs it in. Lewis Burks turns around.
That hit the shot clock. See how high that went up?
I don't know how they call it a shot. I mean, lost it. And that foul is going to be on Daniel Mendes. Starting to get exciting. And that free throw was made by Lewis Burks. Gateway, just like Bristol, they use everybody on their roster. A lot of players in their roster.
Oh, missed the second one.
Missed the second one. 2-point lead. BCC could take the lead with a 3-pointer. They could tie this game for the first time. Again, that shot clock winded down. Pope, Jernigan, cross court. There's a shot. Mendes thought about it. Loses it out of bounds. But it went off Gateway. Now there's 5 on the shot clock. Nobody guarding the inbound. You got to put it up. You got to put it up from the top.
He does.
It's good. BCC takes the lead at the shot clock buzzer.
First time in this game they have a lead and they are fired up.
MSP, the fans love it. Newman, the act the other way. McCarthy with a huge three. Clutch, 47-46. But Newman has a chance to snatch it right back away. You want to hear this crowd get loud. Newman. Newman trying to make BCC's lead short-lived.
Yeah, just lost the lead as quick as they got it.
That was BCC's first lead they've ever had in this game. Well, it might have been their first lead since they had the lead 2-0, maybe. If my memory's right. Either way, it's been a long time. And just like that, Gateway gets the lead right back. It's going to be a seesaw battle. Both teams at the double bonus. Both teams with 10 team fouls. Gateway still playing immense defense. Still making BCC work for everything they got. In the corner for three. Mendez, no good.
So close.
Tipped up. Kamara with the rebound. Long pass by Newman. On the other end, Burks lays it in. And it's back to a three-point lead. Wow. Just like that, back to a three-point lead. BCC had the lead for a second. Oh, Baker right there. That's it. He hasn't had a shot to get that position all game. More or less.
That was a good job by BCC catching Gateway napping.
They were napping on that one because they've had that covered all game. Armstrong gets it to Burks, lays it in.
Jernigan slow to get up.
Another three. Do they count the basket? Jernigan's down and got shaken up a little bit. He's been shaken up a couple times in this game, I believe. Gateway is going to call the timeout. Do they score the basket? They still got the basket up there, so it's 52-49. 4 minutes and 3 seconds. So you said, Craig, BCC needed to change up their offensive strategy, the way they were approaching themselves offensively, and they've come back into this game to get it to within three, taking the lead there for a couple seconds until Gateway, the Lions, snatched it right back from them very quickly. But BCC is scratch and claw. They played better defense, and they put that press on them. They've been playing man-to-man all over the court, causing turnovers. They've got themselves back into this game.
Yeah, definitely got a ball game here.
Yeah.
Still one of the lower scoring games that really picked up the pace the second half.
Yeah, so just like I thought they would. BCC is too good of a team, and they got too many weapons. They got too many guys that can score to be held down for too long. But Gateway's still playing a good defensive basketball game, but offensively efficient. They really haven't been offensively efficient. Neither team has. 52-49. We're getting to that time of the year where teams are jockeying for position in Region 21. Trying to play their best basketball going into the tournament time. And these are two teams that could face each other in the postseason. But Gateway traveled a long way to get here today. Coming from New Haven, Connecticut, it's a few-hour ride.
Confusion on the court, calling for illegal substitution as Jose Mercado's in for Jernigan, but Jernigan's injured, so that's why Mercado's in it.
Well, hopefully he can add some scoring punch.
Yeah, Mercado's been cold this game. Hopefully he can start to heat up.
They could use it at money time. Mendez loves that shot for the wing. Up fake. Air ball. And Baker knocked it off of... Baker knocked that off of... Off of number 34, Lewis Burks. Good heads-up play by the Baker man. 3:45 left to play. BCC's going to call the timeout. Rob Del Lue talking to his squad. We'll keep it right here for you. It's Cardoza and Salvador on the call. With DP. And we're getting down to the nitty gritty.
Both teams at 10 team fouls.
Yeah, both teams in the double bonus. So who could hit their free throws down the stretch? Both teams really haven't done a good job of it.
No.
Especially BCC.
Yeah, everyone's been inconsistent from the foul line.
Everybody's been inconsistent shooting the ball from everywhere.
Yeah.
It's really been a pretty much an ugly game.
Yeah. Especially for their standards. We've seen them play much better pretty much throughout the entire season.
We've seen them come out and play much better. I mean, they really fought themselves. They really fought their – they really did a good job of fighting back in the second half. And it's because of their defense. Their defense picked up.
I think that's what their problem was with the first half was Gateway just really took them out of their element.
Yeah.
You know, BCC was not expecting the type of defense that Gateway was playing.
Yeah, they got punched in the mouth. They're going to call a foul on Armani Baker with a push.
Wow.
And Gateway is going to get the basketball now. BCC was inbound underneath their own basket. Chance to tie this game, and now Gateway has the ball. BCC is going to need a stop here. Not a smart play. Oh, almost.
Oh, McCarthy almost at it. And it's going to stay down.
Oh.
No.
He kind of did like a – the referee did a fake beyond. He was pointing this way like this.
That's what I was thinking,
and
too.
And then he's like, no.
It's going to stay Gateway ball.
Hamlet, oh, they had a chance to double him. Hamlet now with a dish to Kamara. It's good. Wow.
It is a two-possession game for the Bayhawks.
54-49. Key possession there by Gateway. BCC needs to get something going to the basket. Get that foul call. Losing the basketball. Kamara with the hustle play. Then
they're
he goes out
of
bounds. His arm was out of bounds. Kamara going after it. Slips, falls to the ground. His arm was out of bounds. Mercado back out of the game. Five on the shot clock. Gotta pull it.
Throws
McCarthy
up a prayer.
Falling away. Fouled in the three-point shot.
No, only
they're
giving
saying
him two.
They're saying two.
And McCarthy threw up a prayer with that shot. In fact, as close as it was, it's pretty impressive.
Well, he had to. That was at the shot clock end.
Exactly.
But he was falling away in the corner, and his foot must have been on the free throw line. McCarthy wills that one in. Cut it to within four.
Yeah, we can make this one. It's a one-possession game.
McCarthy misses the free throw. Kamara grabbed the rebound. Kamara's been big.
That he is. He's been a very good player for this team.
Careless play. Careless play by Gateway.
Mendez being smart, letting it roll out of bounds.
Coach John Stewart not liking that.
No.
Coach John Stewart's fiery, man.
I saw him talking to Trayvon Ostrom. Wasn't happy with him.
Well, they've had this game. They had a big lead in the first half. BCC's cut the lead. Nice pass by Pope. And now Baker doing what he does. Baker doing what he does, cuts it to within two.
BCC quick on defense.
They shut that down. Okay, oh, God. Going, spinning in. Newman.
Wow.
He's unbelievable. I can't even get the words out of my mouth. That's He's so fast.
Very, very impressive play from Alec Newman.
How did he?
Oh, he caught that like a wide receiver, spun around everything, and just put it up.
Baker doing what he wants to do now over there. And he traveled.
Ooh.
Wow.
Crazy.
Well, what about Newman on the other end? I feel like he saved this game.
He might have, just how Gateway's been playing. That is big.
I don't.
They're calling a foul on McCarthy.
And that's going to be two shots. I'm not sure what. I thought BCC came out with more full court pressure, I thought, at the beginning of this half. And just when you think they're going to do it again, they kind of lay off. They're playing man-to-man, but I would like to see them go into more of a full court press. Because they need to get the basketball.
Yeah, exactly.
They're not trapping in the half court. They're not flying to the basketball the way that they're capable, the way that they can.
Newman drains both.
Two possession ball game now.
Yeah, Newman's been big for this team too.
He really has.
Especially as the smallest guy.
He's kind of been a polarizing figure. Jernigan off the glass, driving the lane. That's a big shot.
Wrong team, Dave.
Yeah. And Newman on the brain. Oh, kick the basketball.
Oh, Hamlet.
That's a good timeout call. That ball was, it was getting kind of.
It was getting antsy down there.
Yeah, it was getting kind of antsy, kind of schizoid over there. Getting kind of helter-skelter. And Newman. Newman calls a timeout. Heard one of the assistant coaches say, relax. Assistant coach Mark Scott telling Newman to relax. But I think that was a good call. That was getting dicey down there. Be safe, reset.
Especially with how close this is. You know, Gateway couldn't afford that. You know, lose the ball on a turnover right there.
No. And that's
the opposite of what they want.
Yeah, it was getting kind of sketchy. They kicked the ball. The ball's loose. Yep.
And Hamlet with the most powerful pass I've seen today.
Most powerful pass. Yeah, Hamlet's been good. But so hasn't. I mean, A.J. Newman has done some unbelievable things. That last play, spinning seemingly out of control in the open court, but then just lays it up with ease and control.
It is everything about that play from him, from the catch to the spin to the layup, just everything.
Yeah, everything in the open floor. It's unbelievable. And so small at 5'9", he's like Isaiah Thomas out there.
Yeah, exactly. He's definitely their leading scorer.
Yeah, he definitely for sure is, and he's only a freshman. But he's really small in stature. I mean, he only weighs 159 pounds, soaking wet.
Yeah, smallest guy, height and weight.
And probably the biggest heart and probably their biggest, best player. And a leader, effectively. I mean, he's had a couple questionable things today with some technical foul calls and definitely an emotional player, you can tell, but. I'm not sure if those technical fouls were even worthy. The inbound. Pope staying with Newman. Evans Antoine with the basketball. 10 on the shot clock. BCC needs a defensive stand over here. Here's Newman.
Newman.
3 on the shot clock. Puts it up for 3 off the glass. Does not hit the rim, shot clock violation, and Bristol with the basketball and a big, big possession coming up now with a minute 24 left to play. Alec getting and talking to now by Coach John Stewart. No clock, no time coming up the clock yet. That's a good job right there. They need a good possession. Gateway still in that zone.
Oh, nice job
Mendez,
by Mendez.
Three-point shot, no good. Coming off, tipped.
Oh, less than a minute left.
Burks, loose it. He lost it. And Coach John Stewart is pissed. Going down the court. Pope puts it up. Can't lay it in.
He's got his rebound.
Back out. Mendez for redemption. No good.
No good.
Man, they had their chances.
Oh, man.
And now what are they going to call?
Foul on Jernigan. It's going to be Burks going to the line.
Man. Unbelievable. He missed a free throw. Luckily, both teams can't make a free throw worth a damn.
Yeah, I was just thinking that both teams have been very inconsistent.
Yeah. That's a big miss there. BCC needs another miss.
There's a timeout.
Yeah. 49.6 to play, but that, I mean, they had their chances on that last possession. Mendez is
they
just
did.
Not, they cannot shoot today. There's a lid on that basket for BCC.
It's like one of those carnival ones that are just the same size as the basketball, so you got to hit it absolutely perfectly or it's just going to bounce out.
Oh, I hate those. And you always think you're going to make them, but it doesn't really happen that way.
Yeah. I remember one time I was dating this girl and I took her to my town's local fair.
You wanted to impress her. Yep. You wanted to win her a stuffed animal.
Took like, yep, spent about $10 at that fair trying to win it. And every time it was like, if it was a normal basketball, it would have gone in. But of course, you know, the things are tiny and the balls are overinflated.
I mean, yeah, exactly.
It just bounced.
They just bounced.
She told me to stop trying eventually. I was like, no. It didn't work. So I won something like on the dart throw or something.
How about like the football throw?
Football throw. And then there's the milk bottle ones. So those things are like glued together.
The milk bottle. I don't think I'm sure if I've seen that.
Yeah. Now the one I dominate at is like the, it's the one where like you roll the balls and it's like the horse races.
Like you gotta roll it underneath the thing.
Yeah.
And it bounces up into the like it. Yeah, I know what you mean.
Yeah, I dominate those ones.
You dominate. Not really like a carnival, like a music park person, but if I go, I like the games.
Yeah.
I'm not a ride person.
Oh, missed both of them.
I don't like to get ill. Both free throws missed. BCC.
They got to do something quick. They cannot waste time.
McCarthy going to the hole. He gets fouled. That's what BCC's going to do. Be patient because both teams are in the double bonus. It's almost inevitable. If you take the ball to the basket, get something going to the basket, they're going to foul you. Referees are calling this game tight. A lot of fouls being called. You can't say boo. You can't get away with a smack or a slap. And that free throw calmly sunk by McCarthy. BCC's in business.
Well, this becomes a one-possession ball game.
Already is. But it's a two-point ball game.
We got to get a quick
one
break.
One possession. You don't need to foul them.
No,
play
you
D.
Can't.
Keep your feet. Keep your position. Stay in front of Newman. Newman, fall back three. Oh,
no
can't
good.
Get it to go. BCC has a chance.
It's McCarthy's ball.
Nice pass inside. Jernigan gets it to go.
Tie game.
Holy smokes. Tie game with a chance to take the lead. Bang. The pass inside to Jernigan.
And who
they make contact.
And who else is going to do that but Desmond Jernigan? He's been getting beat up all game, but he is showing heart and he is scoring and making clutch points.
And talk about redemption because we've seen some of the best free we've seen some of the worst free throws by Jernigan that we've ever seen.
But
and Jernigan has a chance to take the lead.
He has a chance.
This crowd needs to silence itself right now.
This crowd's too excited.
Ball sits it in.
And he got it.
1 point lead. Gateway shell shocked.
Oh, they got to cover him.
No shot clock. 12 on the game clock. Pope in Newman's face. Took an attempted shot. Newman.
No good.
Rebounded by
Baker.
He's got to
hold it.
They need
to
foul
him.
And they do.
Oh, A.J. Newman cannot believe it.
And it's a poor thing because that ball was halfway down and it popped up. The basketball gods here at the cathedral.
My God, talk about a comeback.
Punch it out because that ball looked like it was like going down and then it popped out. The BCC fans need to silence themselves because when Gateway's shooting their free throws, they're silent. They got it opposite right now. Mm-hmm. Let them shoot.
Baker's got two shots.
Baker hits it. He makes this. Gateway is going to need a three.
This does beg the question, when is Stopka time?
No Stopka time today. Stopka time is stopped. Stopka time is put on hold until next time. BCC is going to get back. Both free throws made. Clutch free throws by Baker.
He's looking for a big inbound.
Oh, goodness.
He's going to have to step back.
Throw it up. Shots up. No
good. Off the shot clock. No good.
That's it. What a game. What a comeback. Bayhawks doing their best Patriots impression.
They're talking something.
Don't tell me they're going to call a technical foul.
I don't know.
Either way, the time is off the clock. That's going to be it. We'll keep it right here.
Gateway cannot believe this. People are filing out of the building, but this hasn't been an official call yet.
What happened?
They're calling a white ball with 1 second left.
All right, so we're not done yet. Some people left, but, I think the coach for
I think he's just saying whatever.
I think the coach for Gateway, John Stewart, saying let's just end this game.
That's how this be done.
And the referees
going to do it.
Wow, and the referee is obliged. And that's going to be it. BCC with one hell of a comeback. They trailed 32-15. They kept getting close. They kept getting close during the second half, and they finally break through with a big three-point play by Desmond Jernigan that gave them a one-point lead, 59-58, and then Baker with two big free throws there at the end, 61-58. BCC wins their home finale here at Bishop Connolly High School, right next to BCC here in Fall River.
Yeah, absolutely crazy. And, Dave, to top this game off, who do you think our Bayhawks player of the game is?
I think you got to give it to Desmond Jernigan.
Yeah, that was a huge play.
Because, like you said, he's been getting banged up. They kept it. He stood with it, and he kisses his mama there. You got to give it to Jernigan. That was a big play in the game. BCC didn't play their best game today, but, boy, they played big in the biggest moment. 61-58 is the final score. All right, so Desmond Jernigan is our Bayhawks player of the game. This is our last home game, ladies and gentlemen, but stay tuned for more Bayhawks basketball as they will be playing in the MCCAC tournament February 24th and February 25th in Worcester at Quinsigamond College. And then the week after that, the regional tournament, March 4th and March 5th. Myself and Craig Salvador will be there. That's at Massasoit College and DP.
See you in the playoffs.
61-58 is the score. BCC wins for Cardoza, Salvador, and DP. You've been watching Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media. BCC's a winner. Good night, everybody.